To create a test in your course, navigate to the course content area and select the add icon where you'd like the new test to appear. You can do this directly on the course content page, or if you have your course set up into learning modules, you can add a test to a learning module the same way. Select the add icon and select create. On this menu, navigate to the assessment list and select test. This will bring up a new screen, and we have some items to set here. The first thing I'm going to want to do is name my test. The next thing is I'll want to make sure this item is either hidden from students or visible. In this case, I'm going to make it immediately visible to students. The next thing we'll want to do is add the test instructions for students to see. So what we're going to do is press the plus icon. The first thing I'm going to select from this list is add text. This will allow you to add the test instructions for students. I'm also able to upload or insert any content that's required for students to complete the test. I'm going to select save. To continue to create our test, we'll need to add some test questions. That's the next step. So I'm going to head over to test content again, and I'm going to press the add icon. And this time, I'm going to create a multiple choice question that I'm going to add to this test. So a new screen will appear, and you have some options right off the bat. The first thing is this an extra credit question? If so, I would select this box. And then the other option I have here is I can re-delegate the amount of points for this question. And now I'm going to begin typing the question into this text box here. Now, to set up my answer options, I have a few things I can look at here. I can, number one, allow partial and negative credit. In this case, I'm going to leave it as an all or nothing option, where the student would need to select the correct option to receive the 10 points. So I'm going to start listing out my possible answers here. Once I've entered my possible question answers, I'm going to select the correct answer by selecting a checkbox next to the correct answer. If I wanted to add feedback here, I would actually choose the automated feedback option and type in any correct answer feedback or type in any incorrect answer feedback and hit save. In this case, I'm not going to provide feedback for this question, so I'm going to unselect that. So once I've set up my test question appropriately, I'm going to hit save. From here, I'll want to keep continuing to add test questions until I've completed the test. Once I've added all of my test questions and I've designed the assessment the way I'd like it to be, I need to set my test settings. A few of them are displayed here on this screen, but you can actually open up this gear icon to see more test settings if needed. In this case, I'm going to change the due date. I'm going to go ahead and select any other presentation options or formative tools or grading options I'd like to add to this test, and I'll hit save when I'm done. Now that I've set up my test, I can navigate back out to my course content page and find my new test I've created living in my learning module.
We hope this has been a helpful introduction to some of Blackboard Ultra's tools. If you're an instructor who needs support in Ultra, contact UAA's instructional design team at UAA_design@alaska.edu. If you're a student who needs support in Ultra, contact the UAA Technical Support Center by calling 907-786-4646 or emailing uaa.techsupport@alaska.edu.